Hey, it's David, pastor and church planter for the Douglas branch of Wickline. So I was accused or challenged a little while back by someone for inviting and welcoming non-believers to be a part of our church community. So I just want to go on the record to clear something up and say this publicly. You don't have to be Christian. You don't have to believe Jesus is God to be a part of our church community. Furthermore, I'm never going to try and convert you to Christianity. I don't think that's our job. Now, if you come to me and say, David, man, I feel like the Holy Spirit's really been working on me. I've been touched by the testimonies of Christians. I've seen the transformation that happens in their lives. I want to be able to tap into that joy and to be able to profess the hope that you guys have. Then I'm going to love to help you do that. I'm going to love to help make you a disciple of Jesus Christ and to baptize you into the community. That's the church's job, and I'm going to do that. But I'm never going to try and convert you. Jesus only uses the word convert one time that I know of in Scripture. It's in Matthew 23:15, and he's talking to the Pharisees. He says, "Woe to you hypocrites who travel the land converting people, and once you do, you make them equally sons of hell like you are." What? I'm not going to require you to believe something to be a part of this church. Now, there's things that we do that you probably won't want to be a part of. For instance, and we are a Christian church, so worship is one of those things. Right now, we're a launch team, so we're not officially open yet, but we still meet together once a month to worship together as a community, and you're probably not going to want to be a part of that. Small groups, we meet weekly in each other's homes, and we eat together, and we share burdens, and we pray for each other, and then we open up the Bible and read it and try to figure out how it's relevant to our lives and how to apply it to our lives. Now, you're probably not going to want to be a part of that either. But the stuff that we really want to be known for, we want to be known for the way that we radically love and care for one another and the world around us. We want to be known as a church that gets out into the community and stands up against oppression, even religious oppression, that stands up against injustice, that reaches out to the hurting and the broken and brings healing and restoration. We want to be known as a church that makes this community better and more loving. And if that's something that you can get on board with, what you believe is your business. I invite you to be a part of it. Now, you and I may argue a little bit about where we think that comes from, but in the end, I'm going to respect your beliefs just as you respect mine. So if this sounds like something you're interested in, if you look at your 2017 and you say, man, what purpose did I have? I invite you to make 2018 something where we begin to transform this community into something better than it is today. So if you're on board with that, here's how you do it. Just text the word Douglas to 84576, and that gets you on our text list and allows you to know about the stuff that we're doing. And then you can just come and join along at your leisure and be a part of it. So I'm Pastor David. Happy New Year. Always love. Bye-bye.